Happy Saturday, September 11th, 2021. To God be the glory for yet another beautiful day that we can enjoy and experience His grace and mercy and loving kindness. We are mindful of the events that took place 20 years ago today. Where were you? Well, we know that the Lord is with us right now, and He is with the families, even though they have to replay a lot of events in their mind. We are praying for all of the survivors, the heroes, families, just everyone who was touched by that situation. And I think that was the entire world. God is able to comfort, to strengthen, to heal us of our broken hearts. And what He wants us to do is to continue to seek Him with all of our strength, mind, heart, souls, our beings, even in the midst of tragedies, in the head-scratching moments where we just don't understand. In Psalms 53, it says in verse 2, God looked down, and He is still looking from heaven upon the children of men as Adam's descendants to see if there were and are presently, even right now, any that did understand and who are seeking His face and wanting to please Him. He wants us to pursue Him with all we have when we don't understand. And because of today's date, we would have gone to Psalms 11 and 41 and 71 and 101. And we know in Psalms 101, talking about seeking the Lord and placing our vision, our goals, our purpose in His will. David said, this was his vision. This was his determination. I will walk. I will behave myself in a perfect way. Now we know people sometimes get nervous as far as seeing the word perfection. That's a complete wholeness in the Lord. He is the one who carry out His will. Oh, when wilt thou come unto me? I will walk within my house with a perfect heart. When we have a perfect heart, when it's yielded to the Lord, open to the Lord, then He will bring it to pass. But in and of ourselves, we can't do a thing. But when we look to God, His strength, His ways, His wisdom, and we are open to the leading of His Spirit, then He will bring it to pass. And in Psalm 71, the promise is in verse 16, I will go in the strength of the Lord. I will make mention of thy righteousness, even of thine only, because we hope in the Lord. We could go only in his strength and not ours. Because, like I said, we get exasperated, we get tired, we get weak when we're trying to live perfectly in and of our own selves, and it doesn't work. But when we rely on the Lord, and it says, when we seek the Lord and His understanding, then we will not be forsaken. But if we turn our backs on Him and we're like, you know what, it's not worth it, then what do you think will happen? David had a conversation with his son Solomon before he transitioned. He left instructions. And it says in 1 Chronicles 28, 9, it says, and thou, Solomon, my son, know thou the God of thy father, and serve Him with a perfect heart. There it goes, a complete whole heart surrender to Him. And with a willing mind, when we have those two given to the Lord, when we have it so that they're open to His instruction, it says, for the Lord searcheth all hearts and understandeth all imaginations of the thoughts. If thou seek Him, He will be found of thee. But if thou forsake him, he will cast thee off forever. So we want to go for everything that the Lord has for us. Take heed, listen, David. Listen, Solomon. Listen, everyone. For the Lord hath chosen thee to build an house. That was for Solomon. For the Lord has chosen you, Bobby, Mary, Michelle. He has chosen us for a specific task to accomplish because we're seeking him. So, Solomon was charged to build a house, sanctuary. We are charged with specific accomplishments to carry out through God, his strength, being open, being surrendered, having our heart and mind in the Lord's possession at all times. Be strong. Whatever he has called you to do, be strong. And just like Nike thought that they had this phrase first, the last three words, and do it. Just do it. And when we have looked back, we could say, we could have this testimony that the Lord will not forsake us when we are old, Psalm 71:18, but he will allow us to show his strength to this present generation. Amen. So let's do the work that God has for us to do for such a time as this. Lord, we thank you, Lord, that we do not have to rely on ourselves, oh God, that we don't have to get weak and exasperated, but Lord, we will serve you with a perfect, complete, whole heart because of surrender to you. And Lord, we will seek your understanding and we will have our willing mind given to you. And at all times, you're going to lead and guide because we trust in you and you'll bring it to pass. We don't have to do anything on our own, but Lord, we're just willing vessels. Thank you, Lord, for this opportunity. We'll give you all the glory, honor, and praise for what you're going to do in our lives today and for the rest of our days. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.